Hey, welcome back everyone. So in this tutorial, we'll talk about image classification using Keras and TensorFlow. So image classification is a very interesting topic to study. So basically this involves the convolution neural networks in place. So convolution neural networks, Keras, TensorFlow, backpropagation, neural networks, we will see all these things in detail in this particular playlist. So I have tried to end this playlist with three videos. So from data gathering, data cleaning, and then feeding those data into neural networks, and then predicting the model using the model that we saved, and all those things. So let's get started. So for the cats and dogs data set, so this is the link that we can go and download. So I have left the link in the description. You can click on this link and you can download the data set. So once you download the data set, it's around 818 MB. So I have just now downloaded it. So once you download the data set, you will get a zip file like this. So you need to extract the zip file. And once the zip file is extracted, you will get a folder like this. So you can go inside the folder and there will be something called data set, and there will be two folders, cat and dog. So when you go inside cat, there are around 12,500 images of cats. So these are all the images of cats. So if I just randomly click any one of it, so you can see there's a black cat here. So in the next picture, there is another cat. So there are around 12,500 images of cats in this particular folder. Similarly, if you go to dogs, so inside dog, there is also 12,500 images of dog. So you can see one dog here. So this cute dog is here. So there are around 12,500 images of dogs here. So with the data of these 12,500 dogs and 12,500 cats, we need to create a model that recognizes which is cat and which is a dog. So let's directly jump into the code now. So before understanding the neural networks and stuffs, we kind of need to understand how an image looks like. What is in order to understand an image, I just have this in front of me. So you can see there are three channels. This is the red channel, this is the green channel, and this is the blue channel. So any color that is visible to the human eyes will be a combination of these three colors. So this is how the images are there. So this red channel will have a specific height and width. This green channel will have a specific height and width, and this blue channel will have a specific height and width. So basically, this is a matrix. This red channel is a matrix, and the shape of the matrix will be the height and the width. And this green channel will also have its height and width. The blue channel will also have its height and width. For a particular image, these three channels height and width will be the same. So this is how an image is. So essentially an image is nothing but a three-dimensional array. So a three-dimensional matrix basically. So the first matrix being the red channel, the second matrix being the green channel, and the third matrix being the blue channel. So that is why we say RGB. Cool. So now let's get started. So I am using Jupyter Notebook for this playlist. You can use any IDE that you want. Cool. So directly, let's get started with the imports. So so in this video, we'll only see the data pre-processing part. In the next video, we'll create the model. And in the upcoming video after that, we'll use that model to predict any of the value, any of the image that is not present in our data set. So this video is specifically for the data pre-processing. So essentially, we need to convert all these 25,000 images of cats and dogs that we have into matrices. So let's get started. So in order to do this, we need to import we'll import NumPy. So I'll import NumPy as np, and once NumPy is imported, I'll import cv2. So NumPy is basically for array operations, and cv2, you can install cv2 by typing pip install opencv-python. So this is how you install in your command line, pip install opencv-python. So try this out, and if you are facing any issues, just drop a comment in the comment section. I'll be glad to help you. So this cv2 is specifically for converting the images into arrays, and we'll import OS. So OIS is just to specify the location of our images. And I'll also import random. And I'll import matplotlib. So this matplotlib helps us in visualizing. And finally, we'll import pickle. So pickle is just to save the data. So I'll run this. In the Jupyter notebook, you can run by clicking shift and enter. So once you click on shift and enter, this line is now executed. So first things first. So I'll just go to my place where my cat and dog data set is present, and I'll just copy the URL. So here is the URL, so directory. So I'll just copy it, and I'll go back to my Jupyter, and I'll just create a variable called directory. So this is where the cat and dog folders are present, and I'll just make it as a raw string. Once this is completed, so I have a couple of folders there, so I'll just mention them as categories, and the categories here are cat and dog. So I'll create a list with the first element being cat, and the second element being a dog. So once this is done, so now we have the directory and we have the categories. So we now need to go to the specific folder where all the images are present, and we are going to read every image and convert that into an array and save it in a list. So let's now see how that goes. So now we'll loop through the specific folder where the cat images are present and the folder where the dog images are present, and we'll convert all those images into arrays. So for that, the first step that we'll do is we'll loop through the categories variable first. So I'll create a for loop. I'll say for category in categories, and once that is done, so now I'll specify the specific folder. So I want the folder, so I'll say os.path.join. So this is going to join two different paths. So the first path is nothing but the directory. So inside this directory only we have the cat and the dog folders. So we need to specify this directory first. So I'll mention the directory here. I'll say directory. So this particular os.path.join is going to join the directory path and the particular category, the cat and the dog. So I'll mention category here. So category. Before that, I'll just zoom in the screen a bit so that you can see this clearly. Yeah. So now, if I just print the folder, you'll understand what I've done. So I'll just print the folder here. I'll run this by hitting shift plus enter. So once that is done, you can see here C files dogs cats dataset. So we went to the path where the cat is present, and the path where the dog is present. So once this is done, so we are now in the specific folder. Now what we need to do is we need to loop through all the images inside this specific folder. So what we can do is for image in os.listdir. So this listdir is nothing but list directories. So this will basically list all the particular files that are present in the folder. So inside this specific folder, whatever images are present, that will be listed by this as a list. So we'll give the path here. So the path is nothing but the folder. So once this folder, so we'll now go inside this, and we'll now get the path of this image. So I'll say image path equals os.path.join. I'll give folder and the image. So we have now arrived at the complete image path. So if I just print the image path here, so I'll just say image path, and I'll break the loop here. So if I just run here, so you can see this cat0.jpg and dog0.jpg.
So we have reached at the entire granular level of achieving an image. So that image path we now have in hand. So once we have that image path, now we'll call CV2 and give the specific image path and ask CV2 to convert that image into an array. So let's now see how to do that. So we have imported CV2 already. So there is a method in CV2 called CV2.imread. So you can directly say imread. Imread is nothing but image read. So I'll read this image of this particular path. So I'll copy this path and I'll give it here. So this CV2 now reads this image into an array, and we can save that in a variable now. I'll say this to be as image array. So once this image array is saved, I'll try to plot this. So I can say plt.imshow, and I'll give the specific array here, image array, so that we can visualize. So I'll break the statement here so that I'll just view only one plot, and I'll run it. So now you can see here there is one dog. So before going to the next process, I want to say you there are 12,500 images here, right? But you can see all the images are of various sizes, and see this image has a longer length than the width, and this one has a longer width than the height. So basically we need to transform all these images into a uniform shape. So only then our machine learning models will be able to understand. So in order to do that, we'll now change the image size. So in order to say change the image size, I'll declare a variable called image size. I'll mention a variable called image size here. So for time being, I'll keep the image size to be 50. And now I'll try to change the size of the image now. So in order to resize the image, there is a method called resize in CV2. So I'll mention CV2.resize, and I'll pass in the array that I want to resize. So in this case, it is the IMG array, which is the image array. And the next argument is the image size. So it is basically width comma height. So I'll just need 50 by 50. So I'll mention 50 by 50. So this is now reshaping, and I'll just save it to, this is now reshaping, resizing basically, and I'll save it to image array. So now I'll try to run this. So now you can see once we have reduced the pixels to 50 by 50, the dog is now pixelated, so you cannot see it clearly. Say for example, if I now change it into say 20 by 20, so it is even more pixelated now. We cannot say whether it is a dog or a cat. We cannot predict what even the image is like. So we'll try to shape this more to 90. So once it is 90, it is bit okay, but still a bit confusing on whether this is a cat or a dog. So let's try with 100. So these are nothing but pixels. So when I run this with 100, so now I'm pretty confident that this is a dog. So we'll keep 100 as our image size for now. You can choose any image size that you want. But basically, if your image size is less, the computations will be faster. But at the same time, you need to keep in mind that your image size plays an important role in the predictions. So very less image size may also lead to a bad model. So for this example, I am keeping my image size to be 100. So once that is done, we now got the image array. So we now need to have the labels. So labels are nothing but we know that this is a dog, but we need to make the computer understand this is a dog. So we need to give labels to the cat and dog. So basically the computer or the neural network cannot understand what is a cat or what is a dog. So essentially we need to convert that label, either a cat or a dog, into 0 or 1. So essentially we'll use this array that we passed here, categories. We'll use that to we'll get the index of this cat and the index of that dog, and we'll change that to the label property. So I'll say label equals categories dot index, and inside this index I'll pass this category, so which is basically a cat or a dog. So now we got the image as well as the label. Now I'll just create a list called data, and I'll append. So I'll remove ppld.imshow here. We no longer need that. I'll remove the break statement as well. So now we got the image array which we wanted, and we also have the label. So it's now we are ready to say data.append, and I'll append a list where I'll say image underscore array. I'll also append the label. So basically what I'm doing is, inside this particular list data, I'm passing in a list which contains a particular image, which is this this image in the bottom. So I'll pass this image with the corresponding label indicating whether this is a dog or a cat. So this is what I'm particularly doing in this loop. So let's run this. So this is ready now. So now let us see the length of the data list that we passed. So once we say the length of data and I run this, you can see 25,000. So all the 25,000 images are ready now. So the next step here would be, we need to shuffle the data. To shuffle the data is just because we now got all the cats first, and say for example there will be 12,500 cats that the data has been converted into arrays. Basically the images has been converted into arrays, and there will be 12,500 images of dogs. So the neural networks when training will understand cat first, and then they'll try to understand dog. So which kind of makes the prediction of cat in a bad way. So what we need to do is, we need to shuffle the data so that the cat and dog data sets are mixed well. So in order to shuffle that, we can simply type random.shuffle. So random.shuffle, and then inside this we need to pass the data list. So once this is done, our data will be well shuffled right now. So just to take a look at the data, if you type the first element of the data here, so you can see this is an array. So the first element is an array, which is a three-dimensional array, and then you can see the second element to be zero. So zero here indicates that it is a cat. So that is how the data is present here. So basically every element in a data contains a list of two elements, the first element being the array itself and the second element indicating what animal is this, whether it is a cat or a dog. So provided we have the cat and the dog as features and labels, we'll create two new lists called x and y. So we'll add all those features in the x list, and we'll add all those features in the y list. So I'll now iterate over through this random.shuffle. So now I'll iterate through the data list. So we can say for features comma labels in data, and I'll append the features with x. So x dot append features, and I'll append labels here. So labels. So now we got the x and y ready. So now I'll just convert these x and y into arrays. So in order to convert that, we'll use numpy. So np.array. So instead of list, if we have it as array, it will be very easy for us to train. I'll say np.array x. So this will be equal to x. And similarly, y is equal to np.array y. So I'll run this. So that is also done. Now of x is 25,000, basically the 25,000 images, and I'll see the length of y as well. So y is also 25,000 here. So they are perfectly matching with each other. Now we got our x and our y. So our data pre-processing step is almost complete here. So one last thing that I would like to do is, I'll just use Pickle to save these two variables in my computer. So in order to do that, we need to import Pickle, which we did earlier. We have imported Pickle already. So in order to save, we can type pickle.dump, and the first argument is, which variable do you want to save? So I want to save the x variable, and the next argument will be open, and we are giving a name to our file. So I will say x.pkl, which is Pickle, and we are going to write.
So in order to write, we'll say WB. So WB is nothing but write in binary. So that is what the extension of that. So and I'll say pickle dot dump. I'll pass on y, and I'll save it to y dot pkl. And again, I'm going to write this. So I'll run it now. So now the pickle variables should get saved. So this is for this video. The data pre-processing is complete. In my next video, we'll create models using Keras and TensorFlow. So after that, we'll also have a couple of other videos to enhance the model, to use the enhanced model to predict and all those. Till that, stay tuned. Do follow up with this. I'll leave the links in description. You can download the data set. And do post any questions that you have in the comment section. Please share with your friends and subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching.